Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Gals. Today I have with me Beatris, aka Bia.
Yeah.
What do you work on at Microsoft?
Sure. So I work in Azure Security, and then inside Azure Security on the SQL team, this is a security team. And what we do is we run static analysis tools for all CNE, or cloud and enterprise. And we look for vulnerabilities in code. And then we have tools that are security, compliance, and we file bugs. So that way, engineers and developers can go and fix them.
How big is the security team?
Our security team is just 5 people.
Okay.
I'm the PM. And then
for all of Azure?
Well, yes, but no. I mean, it's divided into a set of stamps or instance of a platform that we run. And then we are in charge of the one for data group. So data group would be like SQL, Cosmos, Cosmos DB, okay, and things like that.
The important stuff.
All the data, yes. And so that's what we do. And it's just fun because we get to see a lot of what the teams develop and where the vulnerabilities exist. But at the same time, we're proactive, right? Like what we don't want is that the code gets checked before it's secure. Mm-hmm. So that's what we do.
Nice. So how long have you been on this team?
About a year and a half.
Okay, so, where'd you come from before that?
Before that, I was in the field. So I was a service delivery manager. And what that means is that I used to move customers from Office on-premise to Office 365. So that way they can join the cloud journey with us. And then eventually when they get into Office 365, we will get to use EMS. So the Azure, and then they will go from there and to use more Azure services.
So the security thing's kind of new, huh?
Correct.
Yeah, how did you get into that? You just were like, that sounds interesting.
For me, it was more like security is always going to exist. It doesn't matter if you are on-premise, if you're on the cloud, or whatever comes after the cloud. It's always there because none of us want to get our information stolen, right? So I thought, why don't I challenge myself and learn something new? I get customers to move from on-premise to 365. Now, how can I make sure that our engineering teams are building secure code? Like, let's go back to the engineering fundamentals. And so that's what I, when I started, I had no idea of security. Wow. I can tell you that. Like, I didn't know what static analysis tool even meant. But I've been having an awesome team that has helped me and guided me so I can learn and be an awesome PM and do cool things for our
teams. So how are you learning? Do you just like look at documentation online or videos, or what are you doing to catch up on the whole security world? Because it seems so new.
Correct.
This whole, yeah, but it's like, very important.
So our platform is internal, so there's not much online that I can go and follow. But I learn a lot from the assurance team. I learn a lot from the pen testing team that just sit right next to us. And I get to see what the developers are doing. I got the chance to code myself a feature so customers can send the feedback. And it's just learning more about the tools, reaching out to other security teams that are inside Microsoft and learning from them.
Do you talk to people like Barry Dorans? Do you know him?
No.
He's a huge security guy in Microsoft. What about Troy Hunt?
Troy, oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
Do you follow tips and tricks from people like that?
Yes, or? I do. I do it on Twitter and on LinkedIn and the Plural site. Like, that's just a super awesome tool that we have where I get to learn a lot.
Do you take things he's taught and implement it in your work, or not really? Does it not really apply?
Not really, because it doesn't really apply, but it's always nice to see what he's doing, what he's been up to. Like, he was just recently in the White House, just talking about security and the importance of it. But I just really like to learn like what's going on in the field, right? Like GDPR and things like that. It's not so much relevant to what we do inside, because it's more like we're interested more in like new tools that we can provide to engineering teams, so we can go and look for other vulnerabilities that we weren't looking
before.
Okay,
nice. Yes. Very fun. So, okay, let's get away from the day-to-day boring Microsoft life. Let's go back to Bia as a kid. Yeah. What got you into technology? Where did you grow up? What schools did you go to? How did you get into this world?
Cool. Yeah, so I'm from Venezuela, and I grew up, and I used to love Encarta. So Encarta, like for those of you that don't know, it's like Wikipedia on a CD. And then I was just like blown away. How can I have all that many information into a CD, right? Because like for my parents, they had to go to the library and then go and find a book and look for that information. For me, I was just look for like, what's New Zealand like, or what happened in World War II, or things like that. But everything was on a CD. So for me, I was like, how can I put that much information into something like this small? That was ignite that curiosity for technology. So then I went to middle school in Florida so I could learn English. I went back home. I did the international baccalaureate in my Venezuelan degree, and then I went to Germany for a change student.
Okay.
So I got
was that hard to do from Venezuela to Germany, or are they pretty open? Was it a program that was?
It was through a program called EF. Okay. So a change for I don't remember. So EF is like a change foreign or something like that. But it was a program, and I got to live with a host family in downtown Berlin, and it was just super super cool. Like how different cultures. Got to learn German, got to go to the school, and I got to travel and do fun stuff because I already graduated, right? So that was more of a year for me, like go and experiment and do fun things. And
so at this time, you know Spanish, English, and now German.
German, yes, yes, yes. And so I went back to the U.S. I did tryouts. I got a bunch of scholarships from all over the country, and then I had to decide where do I want to go to school and what do I want to study. So I've always been interested in computers, but I also like the business side. Mm-hmm. How can we make either more profits or how can we make something that people actually need. And then I decided to study information systems mm-hmm. in Wisconsin, Eau Claire.
Okay.
And so
is your family back in Venezuela during this whole time?
Yes.
Wow.
They've been there. And then in Wisconsin, it was just, so I seen the snow in Germany, but nothing like in Wisconsin. So when we get to Wisconsin for the first time, I traveled with my mom. They were putting something called de-icing on the uh-huh. airplane. I've never seen this in my life,
yeah.
right? For me, it was like, what are we doing? So in university, I got to learn how to program in Visual Basic and then like C#, how to use SharePoint because it was Microsoft focused. It said that we use Oracle instead of SQL. But I really enjoy it. I got a chance to do two internships, and then because I was an international student, they asked me if I wanted to do the international business major as well, and I did. So I had the chance to study abroad in China
wow.
and do research in India.
Oh, look at you.
So that was super fun. And then after I graduated, I decided to join Microsoft to the MOC program.
Okay.
So the MOC program stands for Microsoft Academy for College Hires.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you did that, and then it led to a full-time position?
So that's actually a full-time. So when I started, that's when I started doing moving customers from on-premise to 365 through the MOC program. So what the MOC program does is that it trains people that had never worked before mm-hmm. into like a real job. And so how we should treat Microsoft customers, what is Microsoft all about, what are the Microsoft technologies and things like that. Mm-hmm. So that way when you are put in front of a customer, you know how to react, what to say, what not to say, why our products are the leading edge in technology and mm-hmm. things like that.
How did you sign up for this in Wisconsin? Was it just like a booth available and you were like, yes, I'm going to go to that booth and sign up? Or did you apply online, or how easy was it to get involved?
It wasn't that easy, but you guys have, like, Microsoft has awesome recruiters. So where I went to university, Microsoft doesn't come to go and recruit, but it goes to Madison, Wisconsin. Mm. So what I did is I reached out. I always wanted to work for Microsoft because of Encarta, because of what Bill Gates does, like what his foundation. Mm. And that was just a dream. I never thought I could make it happen,
yeah.
To be honest. But I went and reached out to one of the recruiters at Madison. And I said, hey, I know you're recruiting at Madison. I go to Eau Claire. I know it's not the same city, but here's my resume. Is there any talk? And then I went to a talk that she was having over Skype. I talked to her, and it worked out. I sent her my resume, like, this is the reasons why I want to work. I would love to do something related to Office, because that's what I'm more familiar with. And then eventually, within like 2 or 3 weeks, I got a phone call. I had my interview, and then the rest is history.
Yes. Love it. So
yeah.
I know you're very involved in women in tech and mm-hmm. programs like that. It's your extracurriculars outside of your day job.
Correct.
So tell us a little bit about the programs you're involved in and the people you've met and spoken to and the message you're trying to get across.
Correct. So for me, we have a huge gap when it comes to women in tech, but the gap is even wider when it comes to Hispanics in tech. So I help with OLA, which is the enterprise resource group that we have for Hispanics at Microsoft. I'm part of the board and the leadership team that's trying to make sure that more Hispanics comes and the ones that are here, that they stay at Microsoft. And then also I'm part of Tecnologica. So Tecnologica is...
Which is a fabulous name, by the way.
Yeah, thank you. So what Tecnologica is getting... inspiring girls that are in middle school and high school to go into the STEM roles whenever mm-hmm. they grow up. And so what we do is that we travel across the country and go and reach out to those community of girls that they might not have the opportunity or they haven't seen a person that looked like them. Because
mm-hmm.
sometimes it's hard to see what you can't see.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just go there and say, like, hey, this is what I do at Microsoft. This is what my passion. This is how I got started into tech. This is... why coding is a good opportunity for your future. And what we see is that most of the kids that we go and reach out, the girls, their parents didn't even finish school. Mm-hmm. Most of these parents are like, maybe they finished third grade, maybe mm-hmm. fourth grade. The majority doesn't even finish
primary
school. So
it's hard for them to see
exactly
what's possible.
Correct.
And when they see someone like you, oh, that looks like me. I can relate to her. I can be like that one day.
That's our goal, right? Yeah. Because all these girls are so bright, but if they don't have that aspiration mm-hmm. or like, this is what I can actually be mm-hmm. someone, like Bea or mm-hmm. like so many, we have so many role models, yeah. right? I'm not the only one. So that's why we go, and even if they don't want to study a STEM, which is okay as well, we just tell them like it's okay for you to go to college. There's all these opportunities. This is all the financial aid that you can mm-hmm. have.
Yeah.
And for us, it's just go to university, follow your passion, be who you are, mm-hmm. do what you love. Mm-hmm. And that's what we try to do. And it's just been super fun. And then we got a lot of backup from Eva Longoria, which was one of the ladies that's backing up the campaign of Tecnolochicas, and then Univision. So because we have a lot of the parents of these girls don't necessarily speak English, mm-hmm. so we go and speak in Spanish when we have the chance in Univision, and then that way they can also go to the resources that we have and then find more about how their girls can be a Tecnolochica or how their girls can be a possible engineer mm-hmm. or do what they love. And it's just super, super fun. It really fills my heart when I get to see other girls that are like, oh wow, can I be an engineer? Can I work in security? And it's funny because sometimes when I tell them I work in security, they say, so you keep off the bad guys? Do you punch them? Do you work the night shift? And so it's more like, well.
Well, it doesn't work that way, but kind of.
Right, so it's just nice to see like, not just what they see is what's real. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of opportunities that, and we want it at Microsoft, mm-hmm. right? And any tech company is looking for that different perspective or being diverse
and
inclusive.
Sure. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We're a global company. We need to make for the global audience. Our products need to match that. So
correct.
Yes. Well, what is the first program? What was the name of it again?
Hola.
Yeah.
Yes.
So how do you retain women who are Hispanic at Microsoft to want to stay and keep them motivated?
Yeah, so Ola is not just focused on women, it's for the entire Hispanic, but uh-huh. what we do is professional growth, right? We have conference once or twice a year where we bring speakers, or the last one we had Satya, and then we had the chance to hear him about what he thinks about how much improvement the Hispanic community is making into our products. And so professional growth and meetings get together, because sometimes you just need that support from someone that it's just similar to you or similar culture. Mm-hmm. And it's just been great. We just have a new leadership team. We have changed. We always keep together. And we've been growing. So when I started at Ola, we had like only two chapters, so like Redmond and New York or something mm-hmm. like that. Right now, we have more than 10.
Wow.
So it's just very fun to see that there are chapters in Florida, there are chapters in even inside the different organizations at Microsoft, because we just want to help each other. And it's just a nice way when I need help. So one of the good mentors that I have right now is Laura. Mm-hmm. And Laura works in Azure Security, right? So when I need some sort of questions like, hey, tell me more about what the Azure Security org is doing when it comes to this or when it comes to that. And if it would have been because of Ola or because of the CNE engagement when it comes to D&I, I probably wouldn't have met her.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
So, yeah.
Where do you see the future of your involvement in women in tech and Hispanics in tech? And your role at in Microsoft, where do you see yourself in the future?
For me, it would just be nice to see that more diverse background, even if they're not Hispanic, but more diverse background comes to Microsoft, and just keep doing what I do and just keep learning, right? Because there's a lot of things that I don't know that I would like to learn. But I think security is a huge field.
Yeah.
Like, there's a lot of things that I'm going to start learning soon, which is assurance, how to do threat modeling. And I'm just very excited. I don't know what the future will bring, but I just hope that I stay here at Microsoft mm-hmm. and keep doing fun stuff and encouraging and inspiring as many girls and women as I can.
Nice. And you're active on social media? What's your Twitter handle for people to follow?
Beagandica, so Bea Gandica.
Okay.
Yes.
And so you tweet a lot and do you post it much or not really?
I try. Okay. I'm more active on LinkedIn, but
okay.
I also
follow her on LinkedIn as well.
But I try to post on Twitter whenever I can when we do events. One of the recent events that we did was in Westchester in New York, and so we got the Microsoft New York account to tweet to. And then it was just super fun to see girls that just coming from like a farming community, and they didn't even know that there was a Microsoft store at the Westchester Mall.
Wow.
So that was just super fun, and they get to do the Minecraft. Which is just cool.
That's always overall. Fun. I actually went to Peru and did the hour of code with Peruvian students. Yeah, that was an amazing experience. They were way better at it than I was.
No. Yeah, I don't believe that. It's step by step, right?
Yeah, they were amazing. I was just blown away, but yeah.
That's great.
Cool. Yeah. So let's now enter the lightning round. This is a series of questions I'm going to ask you. It's about yourself. You just answer them quick.
Okay.
Don't think too much about it.
Sounds
and
good.
And we get to know you a little bit better.
Okay.
Okay, so first one, coffee or tea?
Neither.
Neither? More like soda?
Sparkling water.
Sparkling water. Yeah. Okay, that's good. That's better than soda. Star Wars or Star Trek?
Star Wars.
What's your favorite programming language?
C#.
What is a gadget that you have purchased over the year or couple of years and you regret it? Your worst buyer remorse?
Windows Phone.
Oh, it's okay. That's fine. What's your favorite TV show to binge watch?
I really like Silicon Valley.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
That's pretty, because it's so relatable sometimes.
Right.
Some of the episodes are pretty similar.
Yeah.
Yeah, to working in a tech community. What do you spend money on that makes your life easier?
Easier? Traveling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You would never give up traveling.
No.
It doesn't matter what your budget is. You're going to keep doing that.
Correct.
All right. And then let's end with, what would you say to the younger generation that wants to get involved in tech? What are some inspiring words for them?
I would just say just keep trying, right? It might happen that the first time you don't get how to code or maybe you just start with Java and it's just complicated, but just keep pushing because it's going to come to you and just never stop learning, right? This growth mindset that we have here at Microsoft, keep learning, learn something new, and don't give up. You can do it.
That's it.
Thank
Follow you. Her on Twitter. Get active in the community. See you next time.